Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media. Today we're going to be talking about shocks and struts. Shocks and struts are some of the most important components of your vehicle's suspension, and they're also common maintenance items or common failure items once your vehicle gets to high mileage or older age. In this video, I'm going to go ahead and talk about signs and symptoms of a bad strut or shock absorber, and I'm also going to go ahead and walk you through a few diagnostic steps that you can go through to tell whether or not you have a problem with your strut or shock absorber, or whether it might be with a different suspension related component. So first off, let's go ahead and differentiate the term shock and strut. They both ultimately serve the same purpose, and that's to make your driving experience more comfortable. It's to remove some of the vibrations and impacts that come from hitting bumps and potholes and different things like that that are on the road. But it's also important for various things like handling, steering, and other safety related features. If you have a bad shock or strut, your ride's going to be a lot less comfortable, and you might feel like you have less control over your vehicle while you're steering it. So before we go ahead and jump into the signs and symptoms, let's go ahead and talk about the difference between a shock and a strut. So when we look at the suspension components of most modern cars out there, there's really two components that I'm gonna break it down into. And that is one gonna be a shock absorber, and two is going to be a spring. The two most common types of springs that you're gonna see is a coil spring and then a leaf spring, which is a longer piece of metal that's kind of shaped in a U structure that's typically used on the rear suspension of vehicles. So the whole purpose of the shock absorber is to absorb the impact from bumps. It is a gas or hydraulic chamber that basically compresses and absorbs any bumps. And then we have the springs. The purpose of the springs is basically to support the whole weight of the vehicle. That's the primary difference between the two, is that a strut has a coil spring mounted onto it and a shock absorber does not. To get into a little bit more technical detail, a shock absorber doesn't have any control over the wheels or anything over the dampening ability. It is not a super important part of your suspension in the sense that you could actually drive without it. The strut, on the other hand, is a more integral part of your suspension system. You can't drive without your strut there because you don't have anything that's supporting the weight of the car. So a strut is a little bit more integral in terms of the steering, handling, and things like that with respect to your vehicle. So my main purpose of walking you through the differences there is basically just to say that both struts and shock absorbers have one main part that fails, and that is the shock absorber itself. As I mentioned, a strut is a shock absorber with a coil spring around it. Coil springs don't really fail or go bad. So with that being said, let's go ahead and talk about some of the common signs and symptoms that you're gonna notice if the shock absorber or strut is bad on your vehicle. One thing that you'll notice is your vehicle could be sagging in the front or in the rear. Typically these fail in pairs. If just one wheel fails, then the other shock absorber, other strut is going to be handling most of the dampening duties, and so it's likely gonna fail shortly after. And so you'll typically notice if the whole front has failed or the whole back has failed. You'll notice a sagging in the front or the back. You'll notice very bouncy suspension. If you hit a bump and your car keeps bouncing up and down, that's because your shock absorber or strut has failed. If you have a lot of body roll or sway when you're turning around in corners, that's a good sign that you have an issue here as well. Additionally, when you press down on the brakes hard, you notice your vehicle kind of nosedives a lot while you're braking. And then once you come to a stop, it bounces up and down a lot. That's a good indicator that you have an issue here too. Another thing could be the rear of the car squatting or sagging down when you accelerate. If you accelerate, it pushes a lot of the weight to the back of the vehicle. And so if the back of the vehicle is sitting down upon acceleration, then that's a good indicator you have a problem. And then a few other things could be premature or uneven tire wear, excessive vibrations or shuddering, especially if you hit a bump or a pothole, clunking noises when you hit a bump or a pothole. If the the pressurized chamber of the shock absorber is completely busted, then you might actually hear like a loud clanking noise, which is the internal components of the shock absorber smashing against each other. And then lastly, if your car pulls to one specific direction, generally that might point you towards an alignment, but if you only have an issue where your front left or back wheel is bad, then it could cause your car to pull in a specific direction as well. So when that comes down to diagnostics and testing to tell if one of these is bad, you're not going to get any engine lights, any error codes, or anything to really point you to this outside of performing some visual diagnostics. So let's go ahead and tick through a list of some things that you can do to test this out. First off, I would visually inspect the shocks or the struts. Most of them now are hydraulically controlled or have some type of hydraulic fluid or oils inside of them, and so it is possible for you to see some oil leaks or hydraulic fluid leaks that are coming off of them, and so you can see some oil lines coming down the side of it. Also, you'll be able to see if there's any serious issue with like the boots that are around them and things like that. And so just from a visual inspection, you might be able to look at something and say, oh, okay, that doesn't quite look right. But you'll also want to visually inspect the ride height of your vehicle. If one of your shock absorbers is bad, it can cause your car to sit just a little bit lower. The best way to test this is going to be pushing down on your front or on your rear bumper and seeing what happens. If you push down on it and your car bounces back up, then that's what's supposed to happen. Your shocks and struts are working properly. But if you push down on it and then it keeps bouncing up and down, then that's an indicator that your shocks or struts are bad. And that is because the whole purpose of a shock absorber is to dampen that bouncing impact. And so with a proper shock absorber, it'll bounce down once and then it'll come back up and rest in the height that it's supposed to be at. If it continues bouncing, that means that the whole weight of your vehicle is resting on the springs and there is nothing to stop the car from bouncing up and down. A third option is trying to brake quickly. Now, a lot of times you can feel this inside the car, but you can also have someone outside of the vehicle trying to watch, and that's seeing if your car is nosediving a lot. You can visually see a nosedive, and then like I mentioned, the car will be bouncing once you actually do come to a stop. And then similarly, you can have someone outside the car visually look to see if you have any squatting going on in the rear as you accelerate. Ultimately, that's going to be the best way to diagnose a bad strut or a shock. A lot of times you're going to have excessive bouncing, or you will notice that your car is sitting a little bit lower in the front or in the back, whether that's while it's standing still or while braking or accelerating. Anyways, guys, I hope this video was helpful in potentially diagnosing any suspension issues that you have going on, or help you solve why your car might be sagging or leaning. If you guys found this video helpful, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future videos.